Metaphors are key for explaining pain to your patients. In a previous video, in the first chapter, I already introduced the spam filter metaphor. Again, this is a key metaphor that you can use in many of your patients. It allows you to explain the descending inhibition, but it also allows you to explain part of the dynamic pain connectome, so part of the role of the brain in processing the input. And this you can do by asking several questions to your patient. The first key question here is to ask your patient, do you see all the messages that are sent to your email account when you open your inbox? Of course, the patient should respond no, because many messages that are irrelevant to me are picked up by the spam filter, which allows me to see only, or at least many of the messages that are relevant to me, and it keeps out a lot of spam. That's exactly how the nervous system works, you then respond. And you explain that there is a powerful spam filter at the level of the spinal cord that keeps out a lot of messages that are no longer or not very useful for the brain to process, just because they are not threatening the homeostasis of the human body. They're not dangerous sensory input, or a sensory input representing danger, and therefore they should not per se be processed in the brain. And this also refers to the example that we gave in the previous video and that we often use to explain the sensory basic physiology to our patients about the sock. And wearing socks does not always produce symptoms or the feeling of the pressure of the socks against the skin of the feet. So this also can be linked to explaining the spam filter metaphor. Another advantage of the spam filter metaphor is that you can also ask another question. As soon as they understand that the spam filter is keeping out a lot of messages from the central nervous system, then of course it's important that they relate this to their pathology. So the next question you then ask is, for instance, when it's a patient having chronic neck pain, you ask them, how does your spam filter work for all the messages that are sent, that are coming from your cervical muscles or your cervical ligaments or your cervical bones? And then patients typically understand that, oh, I see, yes, that the spam filter is probably not doing a wonderful job and is not functioning at all for all the messages that are coming from my cervical muscles. All messages are allowed through to the brain. That's important for you as a clinician then to emphasize. Emphasize that the spam filter is not functioning at all. But also emphasize that the spam filter can be reactivated. And this can be done again by asking questions to your patient, like, okay, what do you think causes the malfunctioning of the spam filter in your neck region? And then you make your patients think. And if they don't come up with answers themselves, then you can provide some answers, such as a lack of physical activity, a lot of stress, poor sleep. Those are all factors that we know that somehow inhibit the normal functioning of the spam filter. And as soon as the patient is at that level, then you can ask a next question, which brings them to the next level, both anatomically and the next level in terms of understanding their pain problem. Because then you ask them again something about their own email account, and you ask them, okay, when you then open your email account, you see only the messages that have passed the spam filter. Are all those messages responded to you, answered by you, or forwarded by you? So basically, do you deal with all the emails that finally enter your inbox? And then typically patients respond, no, not at all. the first thing I do when I open my inbox is to select all emails that I will not even read. And then I respond as a clinician, exactly. That's what I do, and that's also how the brain works. Even when you look at the massive amount of sensory input that arrives in your brain at every single time point of the day, the brain does not have the capacity to process all of them. It can only process a minority of those messages. So you only answer or forward the important messages. And answering an email is somehow a metaphor for the pain, producing pain as a way to warn you as a patient, as a person, about the possible threatening situation. So using the spam filter metaphor is useful for explaining the descending control, but it's also useful for explaining the role of the brain and the dynamic pain connectome. Of course, you can use other metaphors, like the radio button metaphor with the volume knob turning up and down. Again, you can link this to the factors that are able to alter the volume, such as stress, sleep, a lack of understanding of their pain condition, a lack of physical activity, etc. And you can also use the Ferrari metaphor. The Ferrari, of course, is a very beautiful car. And I've been told by people who have driven a Ferrari car that if you just simply touch the accelerator, that the car starts to drive very fast. So it has a hypersensitive accelerator. But even though a Ferrari is a very expensive and beautiful car, it remains an Italian car. And all Italian cars have some kind of dysfunctions. So the brake is not functioning properly. And this, of course, is a metaphor for explaining central sensitization. The accelerator is functioning too good. The descending facilitation is too active, while the brake, the descending inhibition, is not functioning properly.